speaking group. So let me introduce the three. Rosie. Rosie Dean is a member of the Larche Benny Best Hobart community. And Rosie works at St. Vincent's Industry as a cutter of cloth and sorting. Rosie has worked at St. Vincent's Industry for almost 37 years. Good on you, Rosie. And in her leisure time, Rosie enjoys having coffee with her friends and catching up with many other people. She loves music and Larche gatherings. Cindy Treanor, is the newly appointed community leader of Larche Benny Best Hobart. Cindy is also the facilitator of the National Listening and Speaking Group. And I'll put this next bit in after today. Cindy is a singer-songwriter, who's beautiful today, and brings much joy to her community through this wonderful gift. Jo Taylor is a member of the Larche Sydney community. Jo has been part of the community for 19 years. Jo does volunteer work and has just started volunteering at the soup kitchen to assist those who are homeless and poor. Jo loves animals and hopes to do some volunteering at the animal shelter. Welcome.
We're going to talk, as Claire was saying, about ways that core members have a say about their own lives in Larche, particularly in Australia, about how people have a say in what happens in their communities and how people influence Larche Australia in decision making and even on an international level. And we're going to do this as an interview, aren't we?
Yes.
Are you ready?
Yes.
So as Claire said, she talked about RCD, didn't she? So what does that stand for, Jo?
Remembering, celebrating and dreaming.
And that's a way for you to have a say
about your life, is that right?
Yes.
And Jo's actually written a little article in the new Larche book about that. If you buy the book, you could read it. So, Jo, you have an RCD every year? And you get to have a say about things for your life. So about at home?
And things you do during the day?
Yes.
And then you have a celebration as part of that?
Yes.
And what happens at the celebration?
It's up on the screen.
Slideshow up on the screen.
That's right.
And you dream about the next year?
Yes.
So would you like to share some of your dreams for the next year? And one of your dreams has come true, hasn't it, about doing some voluntary work?
Yes.
And Rosie, we have a similar process in Hobart where you have a say. And ours is a bit different, isn't it? So what do you make every year as part of your RCD?
There's a photo album, and they're beautiful albums, aren't they? They grow every year. There's lots of pages. It shows you doing things. It shows you at work, and with family, and with friends in the community. And that has a dreaming page as well, doesn't it, for the next year. So that's the way you have a say about life for you in our community. And I'll just pitch this back. And there are some other things about how people influence not only their own lives, but in your house. So every week, there's a meeting in your house where you have a say. What's that called?
House meeting.
That's right. and people who live in your house sit around together and think about things, what sorts of things, things that need to be fixed, yeah? And things you might want to buy. Because in your house, there's a house and you live in a flat up in the backyard, don't you?
Yeah.
And you get to have a say about who's cooking when and what visitors are coming and all those sorts of things. And you send a message to the board of management at Benny Best to say, thank you and can you please fix the driveway? This is how you want, we want the board to spend the money. And then there's another group in our community and in each community in Australia where core members gather together and they represent each other. In our community, that's called?
Core members council.
That's right. And at those meetings, people get to have a say about bigger things in the community, don't they? So RCDs are saying about you, and house meetings is about your house, and core members council is about the whole community and things together. So do you remember what we talked about last week, we were planning for?
What are you
That's right. So sometimes we spend time at those meetings thinking about not just something that affects Rosie or the people at her house, but what affects everyone when they're spending time together in the community. So important things then. And then we have another thing, Jo, don't we, called the Large Australia Listening and Speaking Group. And you represent your community?
Yes.
How many members from your community are in that group? You and?
Me and Dashley.
So we meet twice a year?
Yeah, twice a year.
For 4 days?
4 days.
And in that place, we think about bigger things. So you have to bring news from your community?
Yes.
You come and present to the group? And then we think about big things like planning for Large Australia. And we organised a big conference last year.
Yeah, big conference.
And our friend Anne Walsh was a representative from that group and went to France just recently. So she became the Large Australia representative. So we work hard. We have lots of things to think about. And the word representation has become very important, hasn't it? So do we only think about people who are at that meeting? What do we do with the photos? The photos we have.
Of people back home.
That's right. We have a photo of every core member in Australia that we bring to those meetings.
Yes.
And when we're thinking about someone, we have all the photos all around the board so we can think about ourselves and those people as well.
Yes.
We've learned a lot about that in the last 2 years. So that's all the different ways that we're helping each other to have a say for ourselves and our households and our communities and enlarging Australia in the world.
It is.
So we'll celebrate that. Thank you.